Journalists flocked to within safe distance to watch. They took turns climbing high to get a better view. Demolition of the seismically unsafe east span of the Bay Bridge is underway. Demolition had been delayed a week to install debris-catching equipment on the lower deck, so by coincidence, not design. Demolition began November 12th, which happened to be the 77th anniversary of the day the bridge opened to traffic.
I think it's pure coincidence. It wasn't planned that way. So what they've done is they've removed the top layer of asphalt from the upper deck, about a couple of inches, and then the first real work, the work that's starting today, is the beginning of removal of 1,400 feet of the upper deck between Pier E2 and Pier E3. That's basically what the points are. If you go straight down to the water, between those two tall points, they're removing the upper deck, and that's going to take about 6 weeks. That's going to take us through the end of the year.
The $239 million project will be split into three parts to encourage competition to keep the cost down. Contractor CBC Silverado, a joint venture, is handling the first contract, the half-mile-long cantilever section and the S-curve at Yerba Buena Island. In this phase, they will remove 2,100 tons of concrete, 375 tons of rebar, and 1,300 tons of steel deck supports.
If the bridge is lighter, it's actually safer. So at a certain point, when they start to remove the bottom deck, they're actually going to replace parts of the bottom deck with timber that equipment will sit on, because then their equipment can be heavier because the deck is lighter. It's made of timber, not concrete and rebar. I would say the cantilever is probably one of the trickiest parts, because it's the section of the bridge that has the least support underneath. I think some people have described it, it's going to look like a bit like a diving board when they cut it in half and the bottom deck's just going to be sitting out there. It's going to be heard more than seen. For people driving on the new bridge or biking on it, walking on it, they're not going to see a whole lot. Early next year, when they start cutting it in half, and when finally they do cut it in half, around early spring, I would say March or so, that's when you'll see a real difference. That's when your vision of what the original east span looked like will change. And they'll truck it off west and east. After that, it gets sold to recyclers who treat it and recycle it, and then they can sell it what's going to basically be scrap steel and scrap concrete.
On the Bay Bridge, Mark Jones reporting.